course, has been one of the big changes between editions, hasn't it? I mean, everywhere reports that it's picking a month earlier than it used to. So we've actually given, I think, a couple of pages to climate change, or the changing climate. And we've increased the number of pages devoted to weather, I think, from 2 to 6, as well as having the climate change spread.
Yeah.
We're certainly more detailed on Canadian wine country, and that which has been a great beneficiary of climate change.
So we're anticipating, you know, droughts to come, which may or may not happen, of course. And actually, it's lifted the level of, as we all know, there are far less bad vintages in the world. And that's affected Germany perhaps more than anywhere else, but the tide is lifting all the ships.
And Bordeaux even, you know, grapes ripen pretty much every year, pretty much fully. And it's helped what were once seen as lesser areas in classic regions, hasn't it? You know, petit châteaux now in Bordeaux pretty much always...
Ripen the grapes.
It's slightly affected in a way, I would say, the hierarchy in Burgundy even. You know, Saint-Aubin can actually, in some years, be a rather better bet than Merlot, depending on who's made it and so forth. Vines seem to adapt, and it's remarkable, really, that... And I see this because I spend every summer in the Languedoc and have done since 1989, so through the heatwave vintage of 2003. When, yes, vines really did droop and visibly suffered in the heat. But they seem so much healthier now, and they're all green, and it's not that they're being irrigated or anything like that. It's almost as though vines have sensed what they need to do with themselves.